there was like rusty petrol sort of smelling stuff around here. So I don't know if the gasket had perished or something. But I brought a new gasket. So let's put that on and see. I bought a new gasket, so I'll put it on anyway, whether it's fixed or not. So to get this tank off, we need to remove the seat. The seat's just a couple of bolts. One on each side, just here. So I'll take them off. Now the tank is a couple of bolts there, but I'll also need to disconnect the fuel line from the car petcock. There'll also be the fuel level gauge connections in there as well. That rubber's a bit perished. I lost this one. The original bolt, so I had to improvise with a bolt that fits and a bit of hose pipe. Now the tank can be lifted up. It'd be wise to pull these off. That's better. Now we should have fuel gauge sensor. Connection. There it is. So that's the tank off. Take it down somewhere better to work on. The tank's on its side so that when I take this off we don't have fuel come spurting out. I love the smell of petrol in the morning. Although it's not actually the morning. They've got to be seriously careful you don't create any sparks on this, because it's hot weather and this fuel would ignite right instantly. There's the petcock. That's the rubber seal I'm going to replace. I mean, there's paint peeling off this, so that probably doesn't help. But I'm not going to go wire brushing or anything, because I can say the slightest spark and I'm history. And the fact you get to see this video means nothing happened. Right. Let me get the new seal. Here's the new rubber seal, or gasket, whatever you want to call it. It's fairly expensive for what it is. It cost me about 4 fiddy. Let's put it on. Hopefully it's the right size. That's your fingers for this. I'm going to try it at that. It can either seal or it won't. Use my inbuilt torque wrench to get them both at the same torque. Right, I'll get this put back on the bike. I'll just do these finger tight in case it needs to come off again. Let's get some fuel. Fuel everywhere. In the olden days, this is how fires used to start in petrol stations and garages and stuff, by people leaving oily and petrol soaked rags in a normal waste bin or on the floor, and then somebody would smoke and throw away the cigarette end and boom. But now, probably don't do that. Right, let's see if it'll start. On. See the filter filling up. Joke. Now I think the battery's dead. There she goes. Right, we're going to leave it ticking over for a bit just to get the engine warmed up, recharge the battery, and I'll check back in a few days to see if that's still leaking. Thanks for watching. I was examining this rubber and it is perished and cracked. I don't know if I'll be able to get close enough with this camera, but it's definitely cracked. Can't really see. I think it was worth replacing it anyway. See the cracks there. maybe just on that piece where that bit joins onto there, there are cracks and it's perished. So it was worth the 4 fiddy.